Make sure you're finding a comfortable position with your feet on the floor if you're sitting, or you can also lie down. And maybe just become aware where you're sitting, where in the room you're being, where the room is in the house or the house in the street. And you can take a deep breath in and out. And another one in and out. And if it feels right to you, on the out breath, just ask your body-mind system to release anything it doesn't need to carry right now. Any stress, any tension, any tightness, it can let it just go. So with every out breath, you're just letting your body relax. And when we let our bodies relax, our minds usually start to relax too. And you can just continue doing that until you settle in a bit deeper. And if there's anything particular agitating in your mind, you can just ask if it's okay to let that go for now. If it's important, you can come back to it later. If you feel like you're getting stuck in particular thought cycles, just when you notice them, notice it and be like, okay, there it goes again. But I just noticed that I interrupted it. And if you can, you can focus on that which isn't thought, on the space between the thoughts. One more time, just see, maybe your body actually needs to slightly move before it can settle in deeper. Maybe there's some tension that now that your body-mind system is calming down, feels like, oh, it actually needs to physically release. That can also be, it's fine. If it's available to you, sometimes even through our voice, like making noise or something, can be a nice release. Oh, even just a deep sigh or something. Oh. Anything like that. Just see how much you can listen to what your body wants to do if you give it the intention of feeling more calm and peaceful. Not checking out, even though sometimes that can also happen, but just true peaceful. Present, alert, but not bothered by what else is going on. And often that can just be enough if we just calm down by breathing slowly and just watching what's going on for us. And it can also help you to invite the quality of peace in, like an energy or like a presence that's maybe not yet present. So you can just ask, okay, let me imagine there's like a vortex of peace, or like a beam of peace coming into, maybe through your crown, into your head, through your neck and shoulders, into your torso and your limbs, your legs, your feet. How does that feel? Is that changing anything else? And I in particular also want you to send it to your heart and to your gut. And just notice, do you feel fully peaceful, or do you feel like there are disturbances that you need to keep at bay to maintain the peace, so to speak? Because in true peace, you know, we might feel a pain, we might feel an uncomfortable thought, but we're okay with that. Like, we have so much capacity and so much resources within ourselves that we can hold all of it. Whereas sometimes when we just focus on being peaceful, it can also feel like, you know, anything uncomfortable is not allowed. But I invite you to just see how much you can make yourself physically comfortable without shutting anything out. And if you do notice there's something that's actually really persistently bothering you, just get curious, just stay with it and be like, okay, is this just a thought pattern? Is it something repeating? Is it black and white thinking, anything like that? Or that maybe actually something that's just really important to me to address because it's something that's not going well in my life or in my work. But instead of reacting to it, as we do so often in our day-to-day, you just can stay in your peaceful bubble and just notice, okay, you know, this is really something that wants my attention. Doesn't that feel good if you just acknowledge that it is something that you will have to act on, but you don't have to react to it? Maybe you notice that your mind is starting to cling to it or like Velcro itself to it and be like, oh, I have to do this and I have to solve that and this and that and the other. You notice that and see if you can let it go. Because like I said, right now we just want to be aware of, you know, what's really going on for us and if there's something bothering us or if maybe not. Most of the time there's something and that's totally fine. The key bit really is that we can choose when we act and when we don't want to act, when we don't want to react. If we're in true peace, like I said, we can let all the disturbances, all the, we are open to whatever is going on within us, around us, but we're able to hold it. And then make the best decision we can on how we want to tackle that thing, be it for ourselves or, you know, for our communities, for the wider world. And again, if at any point you feel like, oh, you're getting distracted and you're starting to think about how to do something or you're getting really itchy and agitated. Again, if it's something you feel like your body just is literally releasing, maybe you've been holding so much tension and it's finally having this like ability to just let go of something, feel free to do it. But if you feel like you're getting agitated or around an issue, just see if there's another way of dealing with it. Like if it's your mind, you can ask it very kindly, okay, can you trust me that I come back to it when the time is right? You can also see if you can connect to any inner resources that you already have. Even if maybe you know what they are, maybe you don't. If it helps you, you can put a hand on your heart and just be like, okay, can I trust myself as a grown-up adult that I have resources within me and in the outside world and people in the outside world that I will be able to rely on when I need them? Start with yourself. What do you have within you? You possibly have your mind that you might be already familiar with, your intellect and all your mental skills. You possibly have your body, physical skills. Can you feel trust? Is it possible for you to access that feeling of trusting yourself that you're able to handle whatever you need to handle? And again, that doesn't even mean you have to do it on your own, but you're able to go out there and say it to someone specific or even just to the universe at first, I will need help. And you will be able to find the person who can help you with whatever you need help with. Can you trust yourself with doing that? And that it is a safe thing to do, to ask whoever you need to ask, be it a friend, a family member, and teacher, even as an authority or someone, like a public service or a child. It could be many, many people who could help you. How does that feel in your body? Just knowing that you've got that, that you know how to look after yourself. You might make mistakes, you might upset yourself, you might upset other people, but overall, you've been managing until now to go through life. And you've been able to keep yourself alive and functioning more or less well. What other strengths do you find within you? Maybe it's something like faith or hope or love, even. There could be so many qualities that you can access if you just tune in. And if you can, like I said, tune into your heart space. So much strength there, so many resources. How does it feel knowing that you can handle whatever comes your way? You'll be equipped when you need it. You've got this. How does that feel in your body? Is it exciting for your body? Does it wanna open up and be like, oh, I can't wait to finally tackle these things? Or is it more like, ooh, yeah, that sounds really good. Maybe you need a bit more encouragement. Maybe there's something else that needs to get on board in your body to really trust that. Is there a part of your body that's maybe still unsure? And is there something that it wants? Does it want to be seen, acknowledged, expressed? Does it need something like a, you know, imaginary hug or love or kindness or just the knowledge that there's an adult you or something taking care? And if you're a spiritual person, you know, sometimes it helps to call on your spiritual guides, ancestors, any, you know, like ethereal beings that can help you, or even just the universe, God, spirit itself. Whatever strengthens you, you can very welcome to connect to that. Okay. And coming back to the peace, how are you feeling now? Do you feel peaceful? You might, like I said, even feel excited that you know now how to handle something. Just strong in yourself, that you know I can rely on me. I'm actually, yeah, I have got my back. And not just that, I'm just, yeah, I'm a capable human, I'm a capable adult. I can do so many things. You don't have to solve an ecological crisis or something by yourself. You will not do it by yourself. Even if, you know, what you do want to do is something quite big, you will hopefully be able now to see how your bit that you can do will fit into the bigger puzzle. But maybe it's something smaller, you know, maybe it's just something for yourself, like getting a new job or moving a home or, you know, sorting something out with your partner or something. Do you feel you're resourced for that? Is there something else? Like, again, maybe you want to shine another quality in yourself or an understanding of something. Maybe your body needs to still understand all the qualities you have, all the abilities you have, the strengths you have. That it is possible to do whatever you want to do. It has possibly been done before, or at least bits of it have been done before. And sometimes even just shining, you know, love or light, kindness, hugs, something, again, like maybe through the crown of your head or maybe through your heart into your body, whatever feels right. Maybe even coming up from your soles of your feet into your body. Just see if there's somewhere in your body that wants to bring in a bit more of these, you could call them energy medicine, right? Like these kind of, it's a visualization, but really make us really strong from the inside out. So is there anything else? Starlight, whatever your thing is, shine it in. Wonderful. And you can just shower yourself with love and kindness and well-being. And calmness and energy. I don't know, whatever you want to do next, just Maybe just be clear how you want to feel if you think about what you have to do next. Hopefully it's not causing you any anxiety. If you do feel a slight anxiety of whatever you have to do next, maybe just stay with that for a moment and just acknowledge that, I'm actually not feeling as calm about that bit of my day as I thought. If you want, you can ask yourself if there's anything that would make it easier. If maybe you're just excited to go, then just dwell on that, like stay in that. If there is something that makes you feel uncomfortable about going forward, like going to whatever you want to do after this meditation, just maybe you get a sense of what it is. That feeling of having to do something, and you not trust yourself, that you just do things in your own time and they're just going to work out fine. It might be something to look into another time, a bit deeper. You're worried of too many demands on you, of not knowing. Maybe you just don't know what's going to come next. If it helps you, you can just breathe out any stress that might arise around that. What's your heart's opinion on that? We've strengthened your inner self, your heart so much. Well, how does your heart feel? Is your heart anxious as well? Or does that think like, actually, I've got this. I know exactly how I'm going to handle this and how I will enjoy it too. Wonderful. If there's anything else your body wants to shake off or just wiggle off or stretch out or, you know, anything it needs to do to feel good about whatever you need. We're looking at before what you might want to solve, but also maybe the immediate next thing, what's happening now. Do that. And you can even ask your body if there's a movement that would help me to put myself into the right ideal state. Again, it might be calm, it might be energized, might be somewhere in between. How would your body like to feel? Does it want to stand up? Does it want to lie down? How does it need to be? And does it give you an answer? You might hear I'm actually doing this with you. So if my voice goes in and out, it's because I'm moving too. Beautiful. And just let's thank your body mind system for being so nice and helpful and giving you all these insights. And hopefully you have all the resources you need. Otherwise, maybe you just go back and listen to a bit again. I just continue to be in the space, and if you're ready, you can open your eyes. Again, if you need to stretch or stand up, if you haven't done that yet, feel free to do so. And just see if you can enjoy that. Even if you have tasks to do, like the ability to actually being able to do them, isn't that a gift? Like, isn't that amazing? Like that you can do all these wonderful things that you are wanting to do and that you want to solve whatever problem might have come up when you were looking at what might be disturbing your peace. You are such a capable human being. You have solved so many things in your life. And you learn more every day. Let's celebrate that. Shine brighter and stay awesome. Bye-bye.